Let's have a look at cash flow projection in OneSuite Drive on version 1.3.10.11. To use cash flow projection, go to Settings and in Cash Management, select option Cash Flow Projection. So we need cash flow projection functionality to plan inflows and outflows of cash, to see if we have cash shortages, to ensure that we always have money to meet our obligation. I mean, we as a company. To see cash flow projection report, go to Analysis, Cash Management, Cash Flow Projection. When we generate report with the selected periodicity for a selected company, we see data about bank accounts and cash accounts. And on each date, we see planned amount and actual amount of cash balance. In our report, we see data pretty much the same, but the planned amount is generated based on data such as sales order, sales invoices, and actual amount is based on actual cash management documents such as bank receipt and bank payment. And let's have a closer look at them. Let's go to purchase order. Suppose we have placed purchase order for 1 million euros. And when we post this document and see the entries, this inventory flow calendar and purchase order, nothing about cash flow projection. This is because the payment terms tab, which is responsible for cash flow projection report details, is empty. When we select this option, and suppose we need to pay on 30th of April, when we post the document, we see that in flow report, a new entry is added on 30th of April, 1 million euros is due. So again, payment terms tab is crucial for cash flow projection. When we go to the report and generate it one more time, we see that on 30th of April, here's our million, and we have negative balance. So we need to find assets and money to replenish the shortage. We don't see the document here, so it's not very convenient. Let's go to Setup, Advanced, and on Structure tab, let's add Recorder. This is the document that makes cash flow projection entry. So now we see the purchase order, and here's the amount. So we've seen the purchase orders. Let's go to sales module, and suppose we have sales order from our customer in the amount of around 26,000 euros. Again, payment tab is empty. So that means when we post the document, there's no cash flow projection register entries. When we select set payment terms, we see they are automatically pre-filled. This is because we have payment terms set for our customers. On billing details tab, we have shown that every payment is split in two parts. One is due in advance within 5 days in the amount of 50%. And this is calculated from order posting date. And the other half is due after 10 days from invoice posting date and in amount of the remaining 50%. So we see that on order posting date, only half of the payment is due. So let's post the order and we will see that indeed in cash flow projection report, only first half is due. The other half is we've seen is due within 10 days when sales invoice is posted. Let's generate sales invoice. And let's suppose that date is 3rd of May. And 10 days from this is 13th of May, here it is. So the other half is due on 13th of May. When we post sales invoice and we see the flow report, here's the due date, the 13th of May, in the other half of the total amount. Let's go to cash flow projection report and update. So we've seen the sales orders, the sales invoice, purchase orders. Supplier invoice as well makes these entries if the payment terms are filled. The other document, we see the loan contract that automatically posts the payments according to the schedule. And in cash management, you will also find cash inflow projection to plan inflows of cash and payment requests to plan outflows. Let's have a look at cash inflow projection. So suppose we expect that 300,000 euros will be paid to us by our client on 29th of April. We do not have any order yet, but we are 100% sure. Here we see that the inflow projection is not posted. Let's post it and see the flow report. The only entry it makes is cash flow projection in the specified amount. So this is for the inflow, and when we generate the report on 29th of April, we see again it's always about planned amounts, the planned amount of 300,000 euro. Similarly, if we go to cash management, payment requests, and suppose we need to pay our employee's salary for April on 30th, and again let's post it, and the only entry we see this document makes is cash flow projection. Again, let's update our report, and we see this amount is added, and we see a little bit of shortages in our planned balance. If we talk about actual amount, then those are registered by cash management documents such as bank receipt, payment, cash receipt, and cash voucher. Those are the documents that register actual movement of money on our bank and cash accounts. For example, if we register, say on 28th, the receipt of 300,000 euros as advance for the cash inflow projection document, and post the bank receipt inflow report, we will see the cash flow projection entry, but the payment amount is registered in a different field. You see, here's the planned amount field, and this is the actual amount field. And when we update the cash flow report, we see that the actual amount of 300,000 euros appeared, and thus the difference between the planned and actual amount is shown in the report. So to sum it up, cash flow projection serves to monitor that we have enough cash to meet obligation to pay to our suppliers, to pay for our loans, and it helps us take preliminary and timely measures concerning cash flow management. Thank you for your attention.